that which doesn't kill just makes things grow.
Hi, Gawker. So here's the problem, the setup, and my proposed solution. I would like to build a screen for my AC unit, my air conditioner outside. You can see it from the street. The previous owner tried to kind of cover it up with some daylilies, but you know, they're short-lived and they're not there year-round. So I thought I should build some sort of screen, maybe on one side, two sides, I don't know. Easily done with some pickets. I've got a picket fence there that I recently refurbished, so I've got a few pickets laying around. I don't want to spend a whole lot of money on this, so I figured I'd pick up a few more pickets, a couple of 2x4s, and I've got some posts already. I've got these metal posts that you put a temporary fence on. I'm going to put those in the ground and maybe just tie the picket panel to those metal posts. I don't want to build anything permanent in case I have to work on or replace the AC unit one day. I want these to be removable. In hindsight, I probably should have built one a little bit bigger, but this is the way it went down. I'm going to build 2 5-foot sections of picket, and this is how I did it.
Okay, so I've been to Lowe's, and I got these Gothic pickets. They're not expensive, they're only $1.37 each, so $40-$45 for the pickets. And I picked up a few 2x4s. Because you can never have too many 2x4s. And these are all pressure treated for outdoor use, both the pickets and the 2x4s that I picked up. One of the neat things about the Jeep Patriot is an 8-foot 2x4 will fit in the thing. It's exactly 8 feet from the dash to the tailgate, and you can get the tailgate closed. So getting 8-foot lumber, no problem in my Jeep Patriot. So that's it. Material-wise, like I said, $45 roughly for the pickets, and treated 2x4s are 3 and change, so you know, $15 there. $60 for this. I can live with that. Okay, we're back in the workshop. I got one bit already, actually, and have it wired up, as it were. I wanted to show you how I actually built it, now that I built one. And that is, something on the workbench here, I've cut a 2x4 to a 5-foot length, and I've laid it out here on my workbench, flush up with the corners. Give me enough square, as they say, for government work. Doesn't have to be absolutely perfect, but I want it to look decent. So what I'll do is I'll start with my first board and a 6-inch mark, he said, looking for his pencils. I've had my gloves on. Let me just say a word or two about gloves. Really shouldn't be handling this stuff without gloves, since it is pressure treated, which means it's endued with all sorts of icky chemicals, usually including arsenic. So if you do have to handle this wood with your bare hands, pressure treated wood that is, don't forget to wash your hands real well. Alright, so I just need to make a 6-inch mark somewhere along here. Yeah. Good luck. And I'm still square on the edge here, so if I just get this little guy, he's wet up here. If I get this little guy about right there, then I can feel how flush it is. Your fingers are great for feeling flushness. They're very sensitive. You can feel how flush something is very easily with the tip of your finger. As long as you don't run along and get some splinters. Or arsenic poisoning, as it were. Alright, so that's it. Get that little guy. You get a 2-inch screw, just a 2-inch number 8, which I'm going to run out of and probably have to go switch over to number 6s. or an inch and three quarters that I've got already. Alright, so that guy's mounted up. Okay, so I got the first one squared away, so the second one I'm just going to put a picket on edge, flush it up, and then don't push too hard because I don't want to push this top out of alignment. And then just get a screw in this pie right here. Now this is real soft wood. You'll countersink your screws very easily, and probably too deeply if you are not careful at the very end there. Also, since they're pressure treated, some of them are wet and they will bleed when you put the screw in. Just let them bleed and don't mess with liquid. Just let it dry off on its own, because it has all sorts of nasty stuff in it. Alright, so that's it. Just rinse and repeat all the way down, and then when we get all the bottom screws in, I'll come back and show you how a one-man, dead-man show works to mount the top screws. On the first fence that I made, I got measuring from the top, and about, you know, I guess like 18 or 16 or 12 inches or whatever, and I made a little mark and everything. Turns out, this is how you decide where to mount this top piece. What you do is you take the fence, and I've only got this one 2x4 attached, as you see. We just tip it down and get it on the flow. Say here in Dixie, go flow. And at this point, we're going to have to straighten up all of our pickets again. But at this point, wherever this board hits is where the screws go. It's as simple as that. It's dead man work, so shop of one. This is it. 5 feet, basically a 5 foot section of picket fence, a couple of 2x4s, and a couple of 2x4s with some metal stakes behind them. And all I've got holding them up right now are some wires, not the prettiest things in the world, but I hope to do a little better soon. So, there you go. Not a perfectly planned out operation, but something I can fidget with and work on and put some flowers in front of. Okay, well that's it, Gawkers. They're 5 feet long, so you can make them longer. All you gotta do is cut your 2x4 longer and put up as many pickets as you want between them. It's basically just two 2x4s with pickets across and a couple of posts. I used what I had laying around. If you want to actually dig a permanent post, that's great. You can do that. And it's the same as putting up a fence, only it's a temporary screen for the AC. And I'll put some flowers in front of it come spring. It'll look gorgeous. Keep chasing the envelope. Whew, that's tired.